Hey everybody, this is Dr. Daniel Choi here from North Texas Dental Surgery Wisdom Teeth and Implant Center, and I want to go over a very common question. Obviously, after you get your wisdom teeth removed, it's what foods can I eat, when can I eat them? I'll answer those questions, and also at the end of the video, I'm gonna answer, I'll actually give you a really big piece of advice to help you avoid any infections. Because there is a certain type of food that if you eat, it can give you a lot of problems later on down the road. When I'm talking about problems, it means that you get a really big infection, a lot of swelling, a hard knot developing on your jaw, and that's again due to a certain food that you can eat that can cause infection. So I'll give you that tip at the end of the video. In regards to what to eat and when to eat it, after your procedure, you're going to be pretty numb, right? So what we want you to do is we don't want you to go home and like be chomping on a burger or anything like that. Again, because you're pretty numb, you might be doing some damage to your lip or your tongue because you're pretty numb. So while you're healing and also while we're waiting for that numbness to wear off, first few hours, immediately after the procedure, if you're really starving or something like that, you know, what you can do is you can have like a shake, smoothie, something cooler that has a little consistency. You know, make sure that you don't use any straws, but you can like spoon that food into your mouth, right? So like shakes and smoothies, that's what I always tell patients. If you're gonna eat something in the first few hours, that's what it should be. The other thing, in regards to diet for the first few days, obviously anything soft, anything liquid, or like, you know, pretty soft in texture. So I'm saying yogurts, cottage cheese, smoothies, shakes, soups, a lot of that type of stuff. So mac and cheese, right? So just keep in mind that with a lot of these foods, you wanna make sure that you, if it is a hotter food, you let it cool down because you don't wanna burn yourself. Also avoid foods that have high acidity levels, like orange juice or sodas and stuff like that. So you just wanna avoid those types of acidic foods for probably about like at least 3-4 days, something like that. Another question that a lot of people ask is like, well, when can I eat more solid foods? Well, to answer that question, I always tell patients, because everybody's wisdom teeth case is different, right? So some people have very impacted teeth and it's more of a difficult procedure. Also, if you got your wisdom teeth removed later on in your life, then it becomes harder for you to heal. You know, if you're a teenager and your wisdom teeth were not as impacted, your bone's softer, you're overall gonna heal quicker, you can go back to eating the more normal foods. So a lot of this, you gotta kind of play it by ear and just like, you're gonna have a sense of with that pain, with how much pain you're feeling, does it make sense to really be opening wide as possible and like biting into a double cheeseburger? Probably not, right? So I can't answer your questions in particular about when you can eat a cheeseburger. You know, that really has to be based on like how much discomfort you're feeling, how wide you could feel you can open your jaws. So you're just gonna have to make your own decision on that. In regards to what I told you at the beginning of the food, foods that you absolutely do not wanna eat. So I just mentioned a few things that you do wanna avoid first few days, high acidic level foods like, you know, orange juice, certain fruits, soda, stuff like that. You know, again, that's probably gonna be like about 3-4 days. But foods that have like little seeds, think of sesame seeds, popcorn kernels, strawberry seeds, anything like that. I've actually seen these foods get caught in the socket. So keep something in mind. When we take out your wisdom tooth, you're gonna have a hole within your jaw. And what happens is that you form a blood clot. And that's why we say in the first few hours, we really don't want you to eat. You know, like I said, you can have some shake, smoothie, stuff like that. Spoon it in, don't like really disrupting that area. But what you wanna do is you wanna get a nice solid clot in your bone so that your bone can start healing. Now, what can happen though is if you eat certain foods such as seeds or like popcorn kernel, stuff like that. You know, I've been practicing for 9 years. I did on over 10,000 cases with wisdom teeth. You know, I always tell my patients, because I've seen certain cases like this, I've seen popcorn kernels, I've seen jalapeno seeds lie in the socket. Last week I had a patient that had, I can't even tell what kind of seeds they were, but they looked like some sort of fruit seeds embedded in his jaw, and he had an infection after his wisdom teeth extractions. Now, this was a month after that we saw that infection. But what happens is that seed can get, or particle that doesn't want to kind of break down and be digested, it basically gets lodged in that socket, and it can like 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 weeks later cause an infection. And you would know that you have that infection because you have the swelling and just like the bad taste kind of coming out from the area. So then you have to go back to your dentist. He's gonna do something called an incision and drainage, throw you on some more antibiotics. So to avoid all that grief and misery, what you wanna do is you just wanna avoid those types of foods, okay? So if you guys have any other questions, I have a write-up below so you can always hit the link and you can read more about it. Well, good luck on your journey. Thanks.